innovation opportunities from this session. So I think we'll start with the presentation. So the first presentation is from Annabelle from Coda Server, and she is talking on behalf, I think, of colleagues in Nigeria about the detection and molecular characterization of F&D viruses from Nigeria. Thank you. The floor is yours, Annabelle.
Okay. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to present the data that were generated in the framework of an OIE laboratory twinning project that exists between the National Veterinary Research Institute in Nigeria and Coda Server in Brussels. First of all, I will give a short introduction about Nigeria. So Nigeria is a large country in Western Africa, which is bordered by Benin, Chad, Cameroon, and Niger in the north. It has over 16 million of cattle and is considered one of West Africa's main cattle markets. The majority of cattle is of the white Fulani type and is kept in a nomadic pastoralist way, allowing the animals to cross borders, boundaries in search of food and water. In some cases, this might cause some conflict with arable farmers due to damages to crops. Currently, there is no veterinary, FMDV is endemic in Nigeria, and currently there is no control program for FMDV. Vaccination is in general not practiced. There are some exceptions. For example, larger farms having more exotic Frisian types of cattle might use some vaccination. There is no systemic surveillance for foot and mouth disease in Nigeria at the moment, and notifications are sporadic. They are sporadic because there is no mandatory disease reporting system and because the herdsmen do not perceive foot and mouth disease as a very severe threat to their livestock because of, in general, compared to other diseases, limited mortality. Anyhow, control of foot and mouth disease virus in Nigeria is important to give response to the increasing demand of products of livestock, including animal proteins by the population. For example, at the moment, less than 30% for milk and less than 50% for meat is covered by the actual demand, is covered by the actual production. And of course, it is also important to gain access to international trade markets. So the objective of the current study was to investigate, to gain insight in the current epidemiology of foot and mouth disease virus and to characterize and gain knowledge about the nature of the circulating viruses. So in the current study, suspected cases of foot and mouth disease that were reported to the National Veterinary Research Institute, NVRI, between 2013 and 2015 were investigated. So in the current study, four states were included in the study, including Bauchi and Plateau states, which are states known for having important and busy cattle track routes. So from clinical outbreaks, the development of disease remained mainly limited to cattle. So from the outbreak samples that were outbreaks that were reported, samples were collected in the acute phase from clinically affected cattle and sheep flocks kept in the vicinity of the affected cattle. From these animals, blood was collected. In addition, blood was collected from sheep, cattle, and from sheep 1 to 3 months after reported outbreaks. The samples were collected, were transported to the institute in Vom, where they were stored, where they were separated in different files, and one portion of the sample was sent to Brussels. To our laboratory for analysis, and this was done during technical trainings and during secondment of NVRI staff at our laboratory. So the first slide shows the results of the bovine sera. So using NSP antibody, the NSP test, the disease prevalence could be estimated at 76%. Serum samples from which enough material remained were further examined for a serotype-specific antibody response, and this revealed that the majority of serum samples reacted with serotype O, serotype A, and serotype SA2, but in fact, the majority of samples showed reaction with more than one serotype, with O and A combinations mostly detected in Bauchi state, and O and SA2 combinations mostly detected in Kwara and Kaduna state. But there were samples that reacted with up to 4 or even up to 5 of the serotypes, including reactions to SAT1 and SAT3. Sera were also examined in RT-PCR, so sera collected during acute outbreak phases. About 49% of these samples were viral genome was detected. Serum samples collected 1 to 3 months after outbreak, about 20% low amount of viral RNA could still be detected. This slide shows similar results for ovine sera. So in the ovine sera, animals close vicinity to outbreaks in cattle, but not showing clinical disease. NSP showed, based on NSP tests, the disease prevalence could be estimated at 64% using SPCE, a similar ratio and division of serotypes and reaction with multiple serotypes comparable to the one seen in the cattle sera was observed. Sera were also examined in RT-PCR with 47% of the cattle, of the sheep sera collected during acute outbreak of adjacent cattle herds being positive, and about 20% of the sera collected 1 to 3 months after outbreaks still being low positive. This slide shows results of bovine tissue samples. So from the acute outbreaks, a total of 69 samples were collected from gum and tongue epithelium. And using RT-PCR, all but one sample were strongly positive. These samples were subsequently homogenized and put onto cells, and we were able to isolate 46 foot and mouth disease isolates. By antigen ELISA, these isolates were identified mainly as serotype O, serotype A, and serotype SAT2, but there was also some reaction with SAT1 and with SAT1 and SAT3 in plateau and in samples from Bauchi state. 26 of these isolates were selected, and the VP1 region was amplified, cloned, and sequenced, and was submitted to a phylogenetic analysis. So 9 samples belonged to the serotype O. 2 of them were collected in 2013 in Kaduna state. 7 of them were collected in Bauchi state in 2015. They all grouped in the G4 serotype of the Africa topotype, and the difference between these groups was about 9% in nucleotide difference. The ones from Kaduna states were closely related to a Cameroonian strain from 2000, and all samples were closely related to a Cameroonian strain from 2000 and from Nigerian strains collected in 2009. 12 samples or isolates belonged to serotype O. 3 of them were collected in Kaduna state in 2013. They were closely related to strains from Niger from 88 and mapped in the West Africa topotype. 9 samples or isolates collected in Bauchi and Plateau state were mapped into the East Africa 3 topotype and were closely related to a strain from Sudan in 1999. 5 samples collected belonged to serotype SA2. All of them were collected in 2013 in plateau states. They all clustered into the topotype 7, but they clustered into 2 different groups with about 13% of 11% of nucleotide differences between the two. One cluster being closely related to a Libyan strain from 2003, and one cluster more closely related to a strain from Nigeria from 2007. So the present results With the present data, we can confirm the circulation or the presence of the three serotypes of foot and mouth disease virus in Nigeria, belonging to at least four different lineages. The data also highlight some of the challenges that the epidemiology of foot and mouth disease virus in Nigeria is meeting, and trigger some points that might need some further investigations, like, for example, the involvement of small ruminants, especially sheep, in the disease transmission. Also, it highlights the need for further investigation for continued surveillance, because the genetic variety of the observed viruses, to have up-to-date information to assure, to support policymakers in decisions making for the control of foot and mouth disease in Nigeria. And it is also interesting to see that some of the samples, cross-reactivity or activity in antibody as in antigen, is detected against serotypes other than the OA and SAT2. So this was the information that we obtained at the time of submission of the written abstract to this open session, and this was also submitted for publication. In the meantime, we have the investigation of foot and mouth disease outbreaks in Nigeria has continued, and we would like to report onto one extra outbreak. So this outbreak was reported in a cattle herd in Jos South in October 2015, and animals showed disease. It was a cattle herd, about 40 animals, and the disease was reported one day after introduction of two novel cattle into the herd. Sampling of the diseased animals, so sampling of epithelial lesions, was done as with the previous outbreaks and was also analyzed. So both samples that were collected were strongly positive in RT-PCR. They were isolated onto cell culture, and antigen ELISA identified them as being SAT1 serotype. And there was in antigen ELISA no other reactivity with other serotypes. So of these two isolates, the VP1 region was sequenced and analyzed. And the analysis showed that the two Nigerian strains from 2015 were 100% identical to each other, and were of serotype SAT1. 57 SAT1 VP1 sequences available in GenBank were used to construct phylogenetic trees, including also the 2015 isolates from Nigeria. And this analysis showed that the SAT1 strains from Nigeria 2015 mapped out as, or branched out as, a separate topotype we proposed to call topotype 10. The classification as a separate topotype is substantiated by the fact that the differences in nucleotide between the 2015 Nigerian strains and each of the other strains in the tree is 21 to 35%, whereas within each of the described topotypes, the nucleotide difference is less than 20%. Whether this detection of the SAT1 is the result of a novel introduction or the detection of a virus that has always been there but circulated under the surface remains to be merits some further investigation, but there are arguments for both ideas. For example, the detection of antibody responses against SAT1, and sometimes also in antigen ELISA, that is reported in publications that have been published in the last decade, would advocate for the first idea, whereas the large difference, up to 35% of nucleotide difference with the other strains and with the last report concept of Satwan in Nigeria, which dates back to 1981, would advocate for the novel introduction, as well as the finding that in the GH loop there is a loss of a conserved motive in the Nigerian 2015 strains compared to earlier strains in Nigeria from 1981. So, in conclusion, we can say that this investigation, this work, has shown that at least four different serotypes belonging to at least five different lineages are currently present in Nigeria, and it stresses the fact that, or it highlights the need for continued surveillance, because this high variety of viruses and up-to-date information is needed for decision makers to have appropriate and adjusted plans to the outbreaks to the epidemiological situation. So, in my last slide, I would like to thank colleagues from the National Veterinary Research Institute in VOM in Nigeria, the colleagues of the CODA Serva, the Vesicular and Exotic Disease Unit in Brussels, and also OIE for making this work possible. And you for your attention.
Thank you, Annabelle. That was very interesting, and I think in particular the reports of SAT1 in the region, I think, will be of quite considerable interest to other laboratories. It was one of the issues that was raised at the roadmap meeting when we met only a month ago in Loemi and Togo. So I think that's very interesting. Any questions? Nick?
Okay, two questions. I'm right in thinking that the SAT1, SAT3, in the early part of your study, you decided were cross-reactions rather than real virus isolations.
You mean in the first part of the study? Well, we detected antibodies against, in some sera, against, we detected a reaction in the SPCE with SAT1 and SAT3, but all these sera also reacted with at least two of OA or SAT2 serotypes. And the reactions against SAT1 and SAT3 were inferior towards, when compared to the reactions with OA and or SAT2. With the antigen ELISA, we also detected some reaction with SAT1 and SAT1. But again, these reactions were inferior to the ones detected against OA and or SAT2. And we were not able to rescue any of the viral genome of SAT1 from these samples.
Okay, excellent. And the new SAT1 outbreak, are there buffalo in that area?
I would not say that there is buffalo. I think, although there is some wildlife in Nigeria, compared to other African countries, the contact between wildlife and cattle, farmed cattle, is rather limited, and I have no, there is no report of these animals having contact with wild buffalo. But of course, to be sure to answer that question, you should trace back the whole history of the animal, and that's information that we currently do not have.
So I think Keith has one very, very quick question.
Right. Thank you. It's more of a comment. I'm really, really happy to see this work. I think the whole West African ecosystem, and that maybe actually goes as far east as South Sudan and parts of Sudan. This is one of the great unsampled areas for international surveillance. And so having the, I think it's called a regional support lab in Nigeria, one in Senegal, to begin to address these gaps. You're showing there's four serotypes circulating in that region. And we've only had suspicions of that before. So I think this is a really important finding. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you, Anima. So we now move on to the second.